All right. Yesterday, I had forgotten to upload my VOD to YouTube. So, if you're on YouTube watching this, I'm sorry. And also, this will be 15 minutes later. But you already know that. That is for everyone on YouTube. Whilst I'm streaming this on Twitch, it might not make a whole lot of sense without the context I've just given. All right. So yesterday, I've taken in a, or I've decided that I wanted to make a file system tool to help me in making programs that are properly placed. Also, just other files that are properly placed. So that way I don't have to worry about like doing weird things ex or through whatever files and trying to get it to align perfectly, where I can just make a program that does that. So we started by opening a file system. So theoretically, we could just assume that the file system is open, right? Wrong. That is a terrible assumption to make, since we can just call whatever we can input any command we want in whatever order we want, but most of them might not make a whole lot of sense when the file system isn't open. So I want this next command to not be repeated 1,000 times. I'm just putting this here so I have a bunch of. Bunch of these ready. I want this next command to print out all of the table information for the file system. Now, if the file system gets really large, we're going to have a problem. Again, if I guess if it gets really large, we're going to have a problem either way, since the device won't handle things that are more than 32 bits. The disk device won't handle things. Actually, we're going to need both, so I can just some things just in case I forget. Should probably make this while I'm here. I should not have done that. Here's where that belongs. Not over here. Okay, so the idea is that I will be able to fetch table info, and then if I need to go back to the beginning, I can just reset the fetch state. But then again, I might just do something like this. Just now I feel like this one should be a little bit different, since I might actually check if it's in a good state. In this case, EOF is fine. So this should clear out data, which is our main IO for getting and setting what needs to be gotten or set. Some of these things will have some parameters passed to them, but this is where all the data flows through. Okay. Okay, so file system, start file system, file table, x20a. I'm just reading my fsplan.txt. This thing, just to make sure I have everything correct. So at the beginning, we have 2 bytes. So now I'm past the properties, and I need to write some stuff out. Okay, so from here, we want to identify some pointers. So this would be pointer minus 2, pointer minus 1, and pointer plus 1, pointer plus 2. Pointer 0 doesn't exist because that's, you know what? Just because. Here. Probably gonna have to put this into a loop so that way it will loop around trying to get the proper iterator. Proper iterator value. Means I'm going to have to move some of these actually. I think pointer 0 is going to be moved to here. Okay, so at some point, I'm going to have this code run. Lowercase. Okay, so I need to get pointer P1 and pointer P2 as quick as possible. Even if I don't jump, I'm going to want to get them either way, just so that way I can print out that information. know it's not exactly a reasonable thing, but I do like the lineup, even if it's not consistent for what the lineup is for. You know what? I think I'm just gonna get this in order because it's better than seeking around. Okay, so I think at this point we have read the information we need. So, at least that we've read the pointer table. Still some other information that I want to get. I mean, the file entries is a pretty big deal. I'm gonna save this and pop over here. So in this case, we have a We have everything set up then. Here's where we want to read everything else, but I'm going to it's a 16-bit, right? Okay, yeah, it's 16-bit. Yeah, it's 16-bit. What I need to do here. Actually, I can just copy this code. So from here, we put this data in, but we have to set the offsets. So now we'll be able to print the offsets for what the next and previous tables are like, or where they're located. In any case, one word, or file entries are 16 bits total. However, I can do the interpretation work after the fact. And the I can just store 512 words of information, so since everything is offset, since there's a value at 0, then this has to be B, which is an odd number. Okay, so then from here, we need to read a lot. We do this a lot, actually. So we read the data from the disk, from the actual disk, the file which we got from the actual disk, and then we store that into this. So that would be 0x020B in size for all the data returned by this function, since it's 0x020A for the file table, including the pointers and the setup byte, or the properties, the two byte or two word properties. I think here we're good. However, going to set this to something. mean, I don't think this part should execute since it should always evaluate true, since we already checked this before. But just in case. I'll increment I at the end. Wait, does print automatically append anything at the end? Yeah, it does end line, so I don't need to. Unless I want to have an extra end line, an empty line. Not what I meant to press, but okay. Get something failed. A table is 32 words. And starts at 0x000B. Then we have 16 words, which is 32 bytes. Another for loop. Okay. So now we should have the file name in a setup char, in a char buffer. Sometimes the things that I say aren't necessarily the best things. Yep, another for loop. I have to do this over and over again. Wait, no, hold on. This is an entry. All right, we're good. And the next two words to determine that. Then we have the disk offset high word and disk offset low word now being printed out. And we need two more for size. Interestingly enough, despite their name, I can just reuse the same variables. What? Okay. Probably hit some keys that I wasn't intending to. Not exactly what I was aiming. The rest are unused bytes for later potential uses, or just to make sure that every file entry is 32 words long. already have a plan for this one. And it is a very simple plan. I think this is a pretty good solution. If you don't know the entry format, then you can't really make any interpretations of what it's supposed to be. And thus, it will just default to printing everything out. It doesn't know how many bytes are used and how many bytes are left over. It doesn't know what is supposed to be a file name or what is not. All it knows is that there's some bytes here. Hopefully the operating system running knows how to interpret everything. And this entire thing runs on a loop. Each time that it succeeds in fetching table information, it will then print out all the information related to that table. I then have to allow for setting the pre-FS data, which is what the operating or what the CPU expects to be boot code, or at least the first 512 bytes of it. And Then I have to allow for adding and removing and changing files. If I can do all of that, then I have a tool that I can work with. I've also been thinking about using the emulator for something else. I don't know if it will come to fruition, so nothing yet. I will say nothing yet. In any case, that is going to be the end of this stream. So that'll be it for today. If you're watching the stream, thank you. If you're watching later on YouTube, and I'm sorry about forgetting to upload last stream, but you'll see it. But if you're watching on YouTube, thank you. Going to be it for me. So until I see you again, this is goodbye.